Hey, guess what? It looks like that video uploaded after all, thank God. So, hey. Thank you, God. Well, anyway, I'll continue this thing here. Yeah. All right. All right, I'll continue this. I don't know what number this is. I know that this is probably the 19th part of Sunan Abu Dawud in the spotlight. Sunan Abu Dawud 2, 20, and 50 in the spotlight again. But I don't know what number this is for you. All right, I'll continue here. By the way, if I read my words, I'll be using this on my face. If I use the Muslims, I'll be using the that plus a mock Arabic accent. Okay. Yeah. And if you find one, will it say, okay, I've got to read, I'm going to go back a little bit here. Alak in Arabic. In Arabic means a leech-like substance that clings and sucks blood like a parasite. If true, how come the syrup is called the clot and not the clinging leech substance parasite? How come in just about all English versions of the Quran it says we are made from clots of congealed blood, blood clots, you know? How come the syrup is called the clot, you know, not the leech? Are they in conspiracy to make the Quran sound like it was written by a caveman? By the way, can you find one Quran written before we knew what embryos, before we knew that embryos were not blood clots? And if you find one, will it say clinging leech for clots of congealed blood? Where is that Quran, where is that old Quran in English to, you know, verify that fact? This is the first thing, this is its first meaning. In the early years, we could not understand how a leech-like substance would turn into a human embryo. Tell me about it. And since so many Qurans have it as clot of congealed blood, and since it's called the clot, sounds like old Mo didn't know either. Therefore, when they translated, they used the second meaning, which is blood clot. I mean blood clot, not blood cloth. Why couldn't old Owl have been the best of planners and not even said we are leeches, but instead told the truth and said balls of living cells? For one thing, an embryo doesn't even have blood in it like a leech. It's a ball of living cells with a different kind of liquid in them. Again, why couldn't that sera have been called the ball of living cells? How come the best of deceivers, or and the best of planners, well, it's deceivers too, but how come the best of planners screwed up, causing damnation when we'd later find out that that embryo was never a clot of congealed blood, and that sir, it shouldn't be called the clot, but the ball of living cells? How come? How that sounds like the best of planners to you? You know? Oh well. Today, we know that human embryo is really like a leech-like substance, and it literally feeds on its mom like a parasite. Again, where is the Quran translation, that old Quran, to say leech? Before we knew that embryos attach themselves to the uterine wall, where is it in English, at least? And again, why is that sura called the clot and not the leech? How come? Have a look at these pictures. Can you even tell which is a human embryo and which is a leech? I don't care if they look the same or not. Again, where is that Quran translated to say leech? Before we knew that embryos attach themselves to the uterine wall, where is it in English at least? You know, where's the old Quran? Now, before we knew about embryology, you know, where is it? And again, why is that sura called the clot and not the leech? How come? How could an illiterate man know this 1,400 years ago? He listened to Aristotle, because Aristotle says things similar, like about, you know, about bones forming first. So he listened to Aristotle, you know. or well, the people that knew about Aristotle stuff, you know. So, where in the Quran, where is that Quran translated to say leech? Before we knew that embryos attach themselves to urine walls, where is it in English at least? And again, why is that surah called the clot and not the leech, like Muslims are trying to say now in this day and age? Where is that Quran? Then he gives me. Here's an attitude of Muslim scholars. Scroll all the way to the end and you'll see pictures of human embryo and alak, leech. Now you owe me this. One, show me where in Hadith it says in the presence of the husbands. It doesn't say that in the Quran. You have to go to Sunan Abu Dawud to it to see it. Show me where in the Quran it says outside the marriage, sex outside marriage is okay. It's Quran 4:24, because you can have sex with someone's wife if she's your right hand possessed slave. Show me where in Quran it says raping is okay, or even slightly forcing women, or even slightly forcing men into something they don't want. You have to go to Dawud for all that. It's for Dawud 2:21:50 for that. Which unfortunately 90% of Muslims have to believe in, meaning that they are Sunni Muslims. Sunni means one who follows the Sunnah, the Hadith. Sunni Muslims, being that Sunni Muslims aren't Quranis like you sometimes try to make yourself out to be. When you don't mention authentic and non-authentic hadiths, and don't screw up and say, I believe in the hadith, like you say in this thread a few times. Well, I think you only said it one time. Well, no, you said it a couple times, and he says it later on, too. Again, one more time. Why is the surah called the clot and not the leech? And is there a Quran in English that has it not as clots of congealed blood, but clinging substance before we knew about embryos attaching to uterine walls? Where is that Quran? You know, where is that thing? Is this thing still recording? No, it's still recording. Okay. Ignorant! You say non-Muslims pay higher tax. You mean they don't? You know? You mean the jizya is not higher than the zakat tax? You know? Luck! Whatever the heck luck means. As an immigrant in the West, you have to spend years and go through tons of discrimination before you get your citizenship. Not if you go through Mexico by crossing the border illegally or be invited in by Oblamer. By the way, Oblamer is letting Muslims come in for free and by the millions. As a matter of fact, Muslims are even exempt from the stupidity of Oblamer care. Even after you get your citizenship, you are still discriminated. How so? In Islam, it takes seconds to become a Muslim versus spending years in the West. Well, it only takes seconds to become a Christian, too. Which is more human? Prophet Muhammad said, quote, hurting a non-Muslim citizen of a Muslim state is hurting me. Sounds like you're no longer Qurani, but do believe in Hadith after all. By the way, where is that saying in the Hadith? You know, is it Sahih or weak Hadith? I hope he finds it, because that'd be great. I could use that with Muslims who are trying to saw people's heads off. Those who hurt me annoy God. Really? What about shirk? Sounds like Muhammad and Allah have partnering here, you know. The Muslim state is protecting you, of course. What if you feel paying a higher tax to Islam is seen as bowing to a false god, and you refuse to pay money to that god? What is to happen to you after sacred months are passed? Quran 9:1-5. What then? You are going to pay taxes, higher taxes than Muslims pay in zakat tax. I bet you don't see that as evil, do you? But what if things were reversed and you, a Muslim, had to pay a high jizya-like tax until you said, I confess that Allah has a partner, and his name is Mickey Mouse. And instead of bowing to Mecca, you had to bow to Disneyland 5 times a day, or after sacred months are passed, Quran 9:1-5, you could be killed and have your head sawed off to mindless chants of Goofy is greatest. Would you have a problem with that? Think deeper here. In the West, your disposable income is slashed because of discrimination, as you have to accept lower paying jobs. Sounds like you have a problem with that, if true. In Islam, your disposable income is slashed through taxes. But again, what if things were reversed and you, a Muslim, had to pay a high jizya-like tax until you said, I confess that Allah has a partner and his name is Mickey Mouse. And instead of bowing to Mecca, you had to bow down to Disneyland 5 times a day or after sacred months are passed, like Quran 935. You could be killed and have your head sawed off to mindless chants of Goofy is greatest. Would you have a problem with that? Think deeper here. In the West, your disposable income is slashed because of discrimination as you have to accept lower paying jobs. How is it as bad as forcing someone to pay a high tax jizya until they fully submit to Allah, where the tax is then lowered to that of zakat tax? Again, what if things were reversed and you, a Muslim, had to pay a high jizya-like tax until you said, I confess that Allah has a partner and his name is Mickey Mouse. Instead of bowing to Mecca, you had to bow down to Disneyland 5 times a day or, quote, after sacred months are passed, Quran 9:1-5. You could be killed and have your head sawed off to mindless chants of Goofy is greatest. Would you have a problem with that? In Islam, you can end it in seconds by paying jizya tax, by paying a tax, a high jizya tax. Jizya, higher than a Muslim pays in zakat tax. But again, what if things were reversed? And I hit him again with that same thing about Goofy is greatest, you know. In the West, you have to suffer a generation, and maybe your kids will get lucky if they get properly assimilated. False! For people from Vietnam and other countries are able to come over here and thrive by setting up businesses without any help from the government, period. And then there's the Muslims. The blamers having them coming over here. He's having them come over for free. Giving them houses in a Detroit that only cost them a dollar. Only cost the Muslims a dollar in Detroit. Oh well. That's a blamer. When a blamer said he was going to stand on the side of Muslims, he wasn't kidding, you know. When push comes to shove, I'm going to stand on the side of the Muslims. Well, he wasn't lying. He actually told the truth there. He didn't even say period. Which is more humane and merciful, you tell me, the way it is now, as people from Vietnam and Laos coming to America prove. You ignorant, you say, Quran has many different versions. Right. For why do Muslims always say, if you know the original Arabic Quran, blah, blah, blah. Look, no, Mr. Ignorant, it does not say false. For why do Muslims say, if you knew the original Arabic Quran? You know, I think I've gotten too far here. Yeah, I'll stop it here.